We're going to be talking about beta in the market. What is it? Why is it important? And how can it help you become a better investor? But first, if you are interested in wealth building strategies such as investing, please go down and hit that subscribe button to become a wealth giant. Also, if you find value in this video, smash that like button. So what's beta? Beta is pretty much taking the volatility of a stock and comparing it to the volatility of the stock market. The stock market is known to have a beta of 1.0. Now with that in mind, if you're looking at a stock with a beta greater than one, that means that it's more volatile than the stock market itself. And if you're looking at a stock that has a beta less than one, that means it's less volatile than the stock market itself. So here's an example. Say you have two stocks, stock A, stock B. Stock A has a beta of 1.5. That means it's 50% more volatile than the market itself. So if the market goes up 10%, that means it's going to go up 15%. If this market goes down 10%, that means this stock is going to go down 15%. Now, on the other side, you have stock B. Stock B has a beta of 0.5. That means it's 50% less volatile than the marketplace itself. So if the stock market goes up 10%, this one will only go up 5%. If the market goes down 10%, it's only going to go down 5%. So why is beta important? Beta is important because it tells you how risky a stock is. Okay, so stocks that have a higher beta tend to be more volatile, right? Well, that also means that there's higher risk involved in that particular stock. Whereas stocks with a lower beta has less volatility and therefore is less risk. Now you're probably asking yourself, why would I want to buy a stock that has such a high beta bringing so much risk? Well, this is where beta becomes important and will actually help you become a better investor. Now, high-risk stocks tend to have a higher return, whereas low-risk stocks tend to have a lower return. You want to use beta to diversify your portfolio because you don't want to just load your portfolio up with high-risk stocks, because if the market goes bad, and it always does because history repeats itself, you don't want your portfolio to just crumble into nothing. Whereas on the flip side, you don't want to just load your portfolio up with low-risk stocks because it's slowly growing. It's slower than the market, where it doesn't build your wealth fast enough for what you need it to be in the future. So use beta to diversify your portfolio. That way you have those high-risk stocks that build you up during the times that the economy is great, and then you have those low-risk stocks that hold you up in case the economy drops. Now, beta isn't perfect, all right? It's historical data that tells what the company has done in the past and where it's at right now, and most likely what it'll do for a little bit into the future. Now, new events can arise to where it changes the beta or changes the aspect of the company to where the company could do bad or good. So you want to constantly keep an eye out on the stocks that you are in. That way you can make appropriate decisions when those times come. As always, thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed my video and found value in it. If you did, go ahead and smash that like button. And if you haven't already, hit that subscribe button as well. And I will see you in the next video.